You ready?
My name is Lauren and I'm 14 years old. This is me getting ready for the biggest competition of my life. Like millions of people around the world, I love Irish dancing. I've been competing in Irish dance competitions since I was a little girl. Before I went side stage, I said, oh my gosh, Mum, I'm gonna get a big crown. In 2 weeks, I'm going to Montreal, Canada for the World Championships, the Olympics of Irish dancing. Every Irish dancer dreams of being a world champion, including me. I started dancing when I was 3 years old. When my sister started dancing, I was bobbing around at the feshes and the competitions, and I couldn't wait to get into it.
Just gonna have to make sure you stretch and you warm up properly first.
Kelsey and I, we have a brilliant relationship. She helps me perfect all my steps in our studio. These are my heavy shoes. The tip is for trebling and doing my rhythm, and this is where I get all my loud beats and my sounds. And then the heel, it has a bubble here. It makes you able to do your clicks. I think your family is the most important thing to you out of everything, like even dancing. I'm so lucky to have a family who really supports me in my Irish dancing, because a lot of children don't have that. It's brilliant to have their support right beside me every step of the way.
They're preparing themselves for weeks coming up to the competition, so it's up to the parents to help them to do that as well, you know, make sure they have everything they need.
That's what they call us, dancing mums and dancing dads. That's where you are, yeah.
We train, we eat, and we do everything like a normal athlete would do if you were a runner or if you played football, anything, you know. Yeah. It really is a sport. It might even be more intense than football or anything like that.
When you're side stage, you feel really nervous. You try and calm your nerves, but when you're on stage, that's when it really hits you. Like, oh my gosh, especially at a big competition, you're on the stage and like, wow, I just have to go out and give it my all. And sometimes you can actually feel your heartbeat in your mouth. It's brilliant when you win. Every girl wants to win a big crown. They're really delicate, so they're. I've been working for so many years just to win the World Championships, just to get that feeling and just to actually say to yourself, wow, I'm a world champion. Like, it would just mean the world to me. I couldn't imagine any better feeling in my whole entire life than winning the Worlds. I feel ready for the Worlds coming up this year. I kind of just want to get to that stage where I'm over there and I'm practicing, and yeah, I'm really excited this year. I need to be really focused and mentally prepared, but I think I'm getting there. My main rival at the Worlds this year would be Orla. She's a reigning world champion. I haven't seen her many times this year, so I only really know what she's going to be dancing like when I see her at the Worlds. So that's a bit nerve-wracking, not knowing. And she's the same age as me, and she lives in Chicago in America.
My name is Orla and I'm 14 years old. I've been Irish dancing since I was 3, and last year I became a world champion. It's an amazing feeling, because to give up so much to like dedicate yourself to Irish dance, and then you know that you like won and like all your hard work actually really paid off. Since my mom's my dance teacher, I get to spend the whole day with her.
Just because you won the title doesn't mean you no longer have to do all the hard work. No, it's still off to the side. You do have to do the hard work, and she puts the time in because of that. Yeah, that was much neater and tidier.
I've probably practiced like every single day for like 2 to 3 hours. Gary is a strict teacher, but he needs to be strict so that he like gets us to like work hard. I don't think Gary knows, but we also call him Scary Gary.
Smile! Relax the face. Just smile normally.
Gary is also a world champion, so he obviously knows what it takes to win. It's kind of hard because there's like so much schoolwork and I need to keep up my grades and stuff, but I also have to work like really hard for the competition because it's like so close.
Now, all the work is done. I just want you in, dance it, and sell yourselves. Nobody's gonna go looking for you. Eyes up, shoulders back, and sell it. Get a drink and straight back in.
What do you think about the class tonight?
I thought drills were really, really hard today.
Yeah, those were pretty tough.
I couldn't breathe.
No.
My Irish dancing school is in Belfast, 75 miles away from where I live in Drogheda, Ireland. I go to dance class 4 or 5 times a week after school. It's a really long drive for my mum. Mum loved Irish dancing when she was a little girl, but she never got the chance to compete in the world championships like me. I'd love to win the world title for Mum, to thank her for everything she's done for me. Jared has been my teacher for about 5 years.
1, 2, 3, and go, dance!
Jared has been a world champion 5 times. He is an absolute amazing dancer.
Shoulders crossed.
Sometimes he can be a bit harsh and tough.
Off the ground, stop, stop. Arms, they'll be wobbling. But do you think that was clear? Do you think that was loud enough? No, back again.
It's a really tough class today, but I guess we all have to push through it.
Use that back foot. Lighter.
I'm going to be grateful for it at the Worlds, for him picking on me, because then it will make me dance better on the day.
Did you miss a click there? Bop, snap it right and lift right up and show me your feet. Da da da, da di da di dum bum bum. I'm not happy with those front clicks. Lighter, lighter.
After the class, I have to go to get my dress fitted on again because I got a few alterations done to it, and I just need to make sure that it's fitting me correctly so when I go onto the stage of the world, it's just perfect. This is my lucky dress. I won the All-Irelands in this dress, so I just love it. I love all the flowers and I love the colour. I just love yellow.
It's quite plain in the centre, but Lauren loves a lot of like bling on the dress, so she's got a lot of the Swarovski crystals on the bodice.
It's her kind of personality. It's bright and vibrant.
No, I love it. It is. It's definitely Lauren, yeah. And it's a lucky dress as well.
There's only a week to go until the World Championships, so everyone's practicing really hard. And like me, Orla is busy at school too.
Gather around this table so I can show you the next step in your fuse glass. Ashley, please be careful this week so you don't have to get stitches again.
She didn't get stitches.
Why don't you like dancing in front of everybody? You're so good.
It's awkward.
No, it's not. I was a champion, I'd be like, oh yeah, I'm world champion, no big deal. How much do you want to win worlds?
Like, it doesn't really matter as long as I dance good, I guess.
Who's like your biggest competition?
Everyone. You're so good. Let's go crazy, crazy, crazy till we see the sun.
Here we go.
My friends, they mean everything to me. To know that I can go into school and they're all there for me and they're all really supportive.
Yay! Aujourd'hui, on va discuter le voyage de Lauren.
Miss Fox, she asked all my friends in the class, could they come up with a few questions and ask me in French, and I had to answer in French because, you know, Montreal's full of French people.
Est-ce que tu vas gagner?
Tu just vas gagner.
Very modest.
So modest.
Tell us if she wins anything. We have to like dig for ourselves.
We have to find out by ourselves.
Other people.
They always give out to me though. They say, Lauren, why don't you tell us?
When you see her dance and the final package, it's so amazing that it's definitely all the hard work definitely pays off.
The other day, Jared rang me up and he said he had a surprise for me in Dublin, and he wouldn't tell me what it was.
So you're getting up in the morning doing your skips.
Well,
not my skips, but my exercises. When you should be doing the skips as well.
Do you need to get up every morning before school, Lauren, and like work out?
It's the World Championships, Kathleen. It's not a wee fish in Belfast. It's World Championships.
Oh, I have videos of Jared singing on my phone.
No.
Oh, show us go.
No, you don't.
Yes, he does.
I stop. No.
When we got to Dublin anyway, we were just practicing.
Three and go. And up, but down. But could your click be louder? Yes. Try it again. One, two, three, and go. Down. Cross those knees. Two, three. Okay. Now, one of the main reasons why we brought you here was because I have a few friends that I want you to see before the World's Montreal, just to give you that last bit of prep before the World Championships. So here we go.
In walked Kira Sexton and Padraig Moyles.
Nice to see you.
You too.
I know you've been working hard.
Yeah.
I didn't scream, but I was speechless. I was so shocked. Padraig, I've seen him a few times dancing and he's absolutely amazing.
How are you?
Kira's just an amazing dancer. Like, no wonder she won the world so many times, because I've never seen such an amazing dancer.
What are you going to show us?
The hornpipe. That was nerve-wracking, because you want to dance so well in front of them. So you're trying to put everything into it and you want nothing to go wrong, so that's nerve-wracking.
Where do you think you're strongest, Lauren? What are your greatest attributes as a dancer?
I don't know.
I think it's important that you're able to admit those things to yourself, that you're able to literally say out loud that I have amazing timing, that I'm very athletic. From what I watched, I mean, turning out your feet, I wish mine were as turned out as yours. In terms of your timing, I wish mine was as good as yours. In terms of your jumps and your leaps, once again, I wish mine was as good as yours. I think you're absolutely brilliant at what you're doing.
There's a fantastic spin onto your toes, which is just magic. It's like you then leave believing yourself. I cannot believe that the amount of power that I can hear and it comes out of this tiny body. You are such a strong dancer.
Do you want me to get a picture of you and Kira?
Yes, please.
Yes, go on, jump in there.
Thanks, Paul. I'm sorry, Kira, I'm all sweaty.
Oh, you're fine. No stranger to sweat, are we, Paul? Yeah.
This is my picture with a future world champion.
I can't even describe it. Like, if you had to say on a scale to 1 to 10, I'd say 100. So, thank you.
Check it out. It's fabulous.
Seriously have to go out and look like you belong there, okay? Head up, smile, engage, eye contact, and just sell yourself. This is my heartbeat song and I'm gonna play it. Been so long, I forgot how to turn it up, 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 up all night long. Oh, up, up, all night long. This is my heartbeat song and I'm gonna play it. Turned it on, but I know you can take it.
You're good to go.
all of them weeks and months of just working hard and thinking about it, all of a sudden I was just there and I was in Montreal.
Only 1% of the dancers actually qualify for Worlds. And so if you even win a medal here, you're one of the top 1% in the world.
Over time, you develop more of like a sparkle,
yeah,
and like
a tolerance.
You become more fake.
Yeah.
I love Irish dancing because the music takes you to another place. It's pure art. I really become like another character when I'm dancing. My family and friends are like, dude, you're crazy. Like, this is like no normal in Mexico, but they are very proud of me.
I met all my dancing friends that I haven't seen in a while.
So the practice room's okay?
Yeah, it's good enough. It's really crowded. Really crowded.
Yeah, I'd say so.
This isn't not good.
No, guys, this is too packed.
Maybe if we just started getting ready at the carpet.
Yeah.
Like
legs. When I was coming over to see my dress for the first time, I wasn't like nervous or anything. I was just really excited. I don't know what it's gonna look like or any of the colors.
In you go.
So I have it.
You want to see it?
Do you want to color it?
No.
This is why it costs so much.
Oh my God.
Just take a look at the stones.
Oh my heavens.
And a little bit of pink.
Dying to get it on. You got a slight problem though.
It doesn't zip?
No.
Okay, you pull it. Yeah, it's totally fixable.
Your love.
Bring it tomorrow when we practice and we'll just put it on, just to run through and make sure you feel okay.
One, two, three, and go. Da 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 dee dum bum 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 ba ba bum bum ba da dee dum bum dum da da dee dum. No, the fate. I've told you that before. Once the fate out, dee 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 dum. And where is the sound of the click? No, no, no.
I'm a little bit nervous, but I think that's normal. I think tomorrow, I don't think I should have any fear or any doubts about myself, because I do think I'm dancing well and I feel confident in myself. And at the end of the day, I just have to get up there and dance my very best.
So we managed to fix the dress. We just pulled the darts out. Does it feel too tight? Are you sure? One, two, three, and smile. Da 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 da, and smile, and da da da. Tongue in your mouth. Dee dum, and pull dee dum, bye dum, bye dee. Feel okay? Stop pinching anywhere? No pressure tomorrow. Just have fun, okay?
It's quite hard to go to sleep straight away, but I kind of say to my brain, I just say, you know, go to sleep now. You don't want to be tired in the morning, so that helps.
After months and months of waiting, the big day has finally arrived. How we look is a big part of Irish dancing, so you have to make sure the judges notice you when you're on stage. We all have an early start to get our wigs and makeup done. It might look over the top, but our makeup is our war paint. It gets us ready for battle. I still can't believe that today I'm dancing the World Championships. It doesn't really feel like it yet, but I say it'll kick in when I'm side stage.
want those judges to be like, oh my God, that's the winner. That is the world champion standing on that stage. We have to give it to her.
You've got one chance, okay? One chance. We can't go back, we can't stop you.
I'm competing against the very best dancers, and we all want the same thing, to be the champion of the world. The first round is the hornpipe. We dance three at a time, and you have to be careful not to bump into another dancer. You lose points for that.
What I really want this year is just to go out and dance the best that I can do.
So nerve-wracking when you're up on stage. All that hard work, and it all comes down to how you dance in those 2 minutes. The second round is another traditional Irish dance. It's called a reel.
Second dance because I think because I was nervous for my first round, so I was just like holding back, and then the second round I wasn't as nervous.
And finally I get to meet Orla.
And how's your day so far? Was it good?
Okay, how about you?
Good. Did your dances go well?
Yeah, sort of. How about you?
Good, yeah.
You were really good.
So were you. It was your wig sore yet?
Sort of.
Yeah, I know. I can't wait to get it off.
I know. It's going to feel so nice.
Yeah.
Well, good luck.
Oh, good luck to you too, Orla. See you later.
There are 148 girls in my competition, but only 50 make it to the final round, the set dance. Luckily, Orla and I both get through. It's time for the dance of our lives. We have one last chance to impress the judges and be in with the chance of winning the world title. Orla is on first.
Right before I go on stage, I don't really think about my corrections. I just think to have fun and enjoy this moment because not many people can. And then I like walk on stage and it just like all gets blanked out.
We'll be right back.
I have my set dance to do now, so hopefully I have my fingers crossed and I hope everything goes really, really well.
When we've all done our set dances, the judges add up their scores. Then everyone sits in the hall with their teachers and family and friends while the results are announced. This is definitely the worst bit of the day. It's so nerve-wracking.
Sister is the world champion and I can't believe it. She deserves it so much.
You gotta work.